Welcome to the Concise Net Hack video about the invocation, ritual, and retrieving the amulet of Yendor from Moloch's sanctum. The Concise Net Hack videos show you what you need to know about specific net hack areas without wasting your time. This video shows what you need to know about the invocation ritual and retrieving the amulet of Yendor from Moloch's sanctum in Net Hack 3.6.6. The amulet of Yendor is in, as I said, Moloch's Sanctum, which is a special level below the bottom level of Jehennem. You have to find the vibrating square, then perform the invocation ritual on that square. When you do, the vibrating square turns into a down staircase leading to Moloch's Sanctum, where you're going to find the high priest or priestess of Moloch, who has the amulet. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to find the vibrating square, how to perform the ritual, and how to retrieve the amulet of Yendor. So I am currently on the bottom level of Jehennem. I can tell I'm on the bottom level because although there are upstairs right here, there are no downstairs. And if I were to try to dig into the floor, I couldn't dig down. I have found the vibrating square already. It's denoted here by a tilde. Two ways to find the vibrating square are, one, you can explore the entire level until you step on a square where you feel a strange vibration under your feet. A quicker way, if you have a spare scroll of gold detection, you can confuse yourself and read the scroll, and it will identify all traps on the level and the vibrating square. Note, though, that I recommend anyway, that you save 4 scrolls of gold detection for your ascension. So if you have 5, you might do that. Before you can complete the invocation, you need three items. You need the candelabrum with 7 candles. You retrieve the candelabrum from Vlad's Tower. You can also get candles there. You can get at least 8 there. You also need the Bell of Opening. You get the Bell of Opening from your quest. You need to have the Book of the Dead. You get the Book of the Dead from Wizard's Tower, where you have to steal it from Rodney. And I have concise net hack videos showing how to do those things. I also recommend that you have a wand of secret door detection if you can, because it'll speed things up. So I am going to go ahead and perform the ritual. The first thing I'm going to do is move to the vibrating square that I've already found. All right, I feel a strange vibration under my feet. Now, you can ring the bell and light your candles in any order. Typically, I light the candles and then ring the bell. I'll show you in my inventory that I have an uncursed candelabrum of invocation. It doesn't have to be uncursed, I don't think, but I've got 7 candles attached to it. So I had candles, and I applied them with the candelabrum in my inventory, and it asked me if I wanted to attach them to the candelabrum. So I'm going to apply my candelabrum, and then I'm going to ring the bell. So I'll apply Y, and I'll apply J. The candles burn brightly. Now I'll apply J. I ring the bell of opening. I got an unsettling shrill sound. I think if it's cursed, you have to uncurse it first. You get another message. Now I'm going to read the Book of the Dead. That's the papyrus spell book until it's identified. I begin to recite the runes. I turn the pages of the Book of the Dead. The floor shakes violently under me, and the walls bend and crumble, and I am standing now at the top of a stairwell. I have fire traps around me and then a thick moat. Let's go down into Moloch's Sanctum. I believe I cannot cast magic mapping here. I can't. Yeah, something blocks the spell. So I will just try and quickly go through this Moloch's Sanctum. It's pretty much the same every time. It's the same except for one hidden doorway. Kick the door. Oh, good grief. All right. Levin's search. Oh, I should mention, when you hit a fire trap and you have the Book of the Dead in your inventory, it cannot burn. Okay, kick the door, kill the ghost. This is going to be a little bit tedious. If I blind myself, I can see that I have a whole big graveyard here. I've got priests of Moloch, and then the high priest or high priestess of Moloch will be at this location here. I think rather than bore you, I'm going to pause the video. I'll deal with the graveyard and start recording again when I get close to the inner sanctum. Okay, I have cleared the graveyard here, left some corpses there. If you get lucky, you might get a wraith corpse that you can eat and gain a level. If you want to try, do they call it wraith baiting? Lead the wraiths to the upstairs and go upstairs to a non-graveyard level. You'll have a better chance of leaving a corpse because the wraiths, well, undeads in general don't leave corpses very often on a graveyard level. I've checked all of the large boxes in the graveyard, and now I'm ready to move on toward the inner sanctum. I am encountering a number of priests and priestesses of Moloch. This is a good place for conflict if you like that. So I'll put on my ring of conflict. Have lots of power so I can zap a lot of spells. High level wizards can zap spells indefinitely almost. And maybe a little boring, but give me a minute just so you can see what you have to deal with as you work your way through this level. All right. That wall there to my left, this wall is the wall of the inner sanctum. It is surrounded by fire traps, and there will be a hidden door somewhere along that level. If you have a wand of secret door detection, it's easier to find the hidden door. Also, the Bell of Opening has three charges. If you used one to get down into the sanctum, one spell or one charge to perform the ritual, you have two charges left, and so you got a chance to find the doorway that way. I don't like searching all day on all those fire traps, so let's head over there. I'm going to apply the Bell of Opening again. The Bell of Opening is J for me. So when I ring that, it detects all traps and hidden doors. You can see a bunch of the fire traps, but no hidden door. Let's head down and apply my last charge, apply J, and I found the hidden door there. This room, if you're interested, I could head around and just show you. There are more traps all along the inner walls there. There's one. Okay, let's get out of the traps and let's go ahead and go through that door. I'll dodge the priests and priestesses. Oh, they love to summon insects. All right, Barb Devil. I'm blind, but he opened that door. Apply my unicorn horn to cure my blindness. Okay, there's the high priest. As soon as I attack me, I'm gonna or attack him, I'm going to get hit by a bolt of lightning, but then I'm gonna kill him and retrieve the amulet from his body. Okay, get out of the. There we go. I'll just insta-kill him, but he's not that hard to kill. So Moloch's voice booms, "How darest thou harm thy servant?" The bolt of lightning strikes me. Blinded by the flash, but I did kill him. All right. Now, in his possession here, you have the amulet of Yendor and some other things. I'm going to pick up that amulet. I always name that amulet as real. I'll name a particular item in my inventory. I forgot what letter it was. It was the amulet of Yendor. Anyway, you name the amulet real, and then if you ever want to know if you have the amulet or you have one of the fake ones, one option is to cast a spell. So I'm going to cast Identify. If you feel the amulet draining your energy away, then you know that you have the amulet of Yendor in your possession. All right, that is how you perform the invocation and retrieve the amulet of Yendor. I hope you've enjoyed this concise NetHack video about the invocation and retrieving the amulet.